العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أفضل الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كلام المجيد وفرقان الحميد وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمي الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعثت لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Most honorable علماء الكرام, blessed حفاظ القراء حضرات, brothers and sisters of Iman Islam listening within the masjid on our present radio and inshallah this is after a few days through the internet all over the universe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. A blessed moment and a great auspicious time when the people of Iman all over the universe express their feelings and emotions for the master of Medina sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Aqli mentions in the glorious Quran, part 29, chapter 68, verse number 4. وَإِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ عَلَىٰ قُلُكٍ عَظِيمٍ. O beloved, indeed you are the possessor of great etiquette, great manners. And this is the main and focal point of the spreading of Islam and the love of Mustafa Kareem all over the universe. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from childhood all through the age up to 63 years expressed and portrayed Islam through his character. And in the next few moments, I will mention how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam impressed other people by that character which was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We see the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam has not been created within this dunya. Imam Ibn Kathir writes in Al-Bidayah wa Nihaya, volume 2, page 91. He says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exalted the maqam of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for which today the mu'mineen always praise and send durood wa salam in the court of Allah Rasul alayhi salatu wa salam. Imam Ibn Kathir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, under the verse of the Quran, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِن رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ. That Al-Aqli taught Adam alayhi salatu wasalam some specific words. That Adam said these words and I will forgive you. We asked Imam Ibn Kathir radiallahu ta'ala, what were these words that he taught Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam? That for this clean mistake, this paak khata, as I have been mentioning in the durus of Mishkat al-Masabih, on the words of Imam Waliuddin Muhammad bin Abdullah Tabrizi al-Umari, who writes that this khata was a clean and a paak khata. What did Allah teach Adam alayhi salatu wasalam? Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was walking through the gardens of Jannah. And we see that Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam looked upon the throne, upon the pillars of the throne, and he saw the name of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam next to the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was written, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. So he says, O Lord, I ask you to forgive me for the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah Kareem says, O Adam alayhi salam, I have not created my beloved. How have you recognized him? And he says, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَرَعَيْتُ مَكْتُوبًا عَلَىٰ كَوَائِنِ الْعَرْشِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ مُحَمَّدُ رَسُولُ اللَّهُ. Mawla, I lifted my head and I saw that this declaration of faith was written. And next to your name was the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I believe that he must be someone very beloved to you, very close to you. Or Adam, why not ask the sake of this being? And Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam asks in the court of Allah, oh Allah, forgive me bihaqqi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Forgive me for the sake of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O Adam, sadaqta ya Adam. Innahu la'ahabbul khalqi alayya. He is the most beloved to me from all creation. And if I had not created him, I wouldn't have created him. So we see that the forgiveness of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was made due to the name of Mustafa Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That's why we see today that people present themselves in the court of Mustafa Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They weep and shed tears before the shrine of Aqa alayhi salatu wasalam, before the feet of Mustafa Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because they know that if we are going to be successful in the court of Allah, if anybody is going to vouch for us, to safarish and shafaat for us, it is going to be the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we have all heard and read the hadith of Imam Muslim radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the hadith of shafa'ah, the sahih hadith, which he has mentioned that how the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will ask for forgiveness for all the people of the universe. A hadith comes to mind here that there is a sahabi rasul and he is blind. And this hadith and the wordings of this hadith are mentioned in the namaz book of Hazratul Allam Mawlana Muhammad Shafi Al-Qarbi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. This dua is mentioned in there. And it is also mentioned in the book written by a Sheikh Salim al-Hashmi as well. A sahabi rasul comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says, O Allah rasul, I am blind. O Allah rasul, make dua for me that Allah bestow nur in my eyes. Allah give me nur. Allah give me light. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stayed quiet. And I've also mentioned in the durus of Mishkat al-Mazamir that why did the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam many times stay quiet? 3 times. Second time he asked to Allah Rasul, make dua for me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow nur in my eyes. Mustafa Kareem alayhi salatu wasalam stays quiet again. He says, oh Allah Rasul, make dua for me. Mustafa jaan rahmat pe lakum salam stays quiet again. And then says, why don't you make dua and lift your hands in the court of Allah and ask Allah Kareem, Allahumma inni as'aluka wa atawajjahu ilayka bi nabiyyika Muhammadin nabiyyi rahma ya Rasulullah inni qad tawajjahtu bika ila rabbi fi halati hadhihi lituqdali Allahumma fashfi hufiya. Oh Allah Kareem, I present myself in your court and with me I take the attention of Mustafa Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Oh Allah, take this difficulty away of mine. Take this problem and solve this problem away from of mine. And give me solution and bestow shafa'ah for the sake of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that sahabi rasul makes that dua. And the other blessed companions, they say a few days later, kuch din jab guzre, to wohi sahabi rasul, jo nabina te, jab unhune ye iltija rab ki bargah mein ki, ke maula mujhe Mustafa Kareem ke sadqe se, aankhun mein noor ata farma, to Allah it feels as if though he was never blind, because he asked Allah Kareem for the sake of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And indeed, an issue of intermediary and taking the wasila of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam is one of the main principles of the aqeedah of a Muslim, which everybody should be well aware and have knowledge about. I would like to draw your attention to the verse of the glorious Quran that, beloved, you possess excellent morals and manners. Before me, I have one of the masterpieces of writings of someone who was a masterpiece himself on the name of Dawul Ummah, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And in the biography of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, most honorable Dawul Ummah radiallahu anhu writes, he says that there was a time when there was the army of Muslims who would return from an expedition. And there was a time once when Aqa alayhi salatu wasalam returned. Lashkar-e-Islam jihad se ek dafa wapas aa raha tha. Aur muhaddiseen likhte hain ki dopahar ka waqt tha. Garmi بڑی زبردست تھی، دھوپ بھی اپنی تابانیاں دکھا رہی تھی، تو آقا علیہ السلام نے اپنے ہر ایک صحابی رسول کو ہر درخت کے نیچے لیٹنے کی اجازت عطا فرمائی کہ یہاں قید اللہ فرما. So they've come back from an expedition, a battle, and they have been given the permission by the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to rest under the shades of the trees. The Rabi narrator says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam saw a tree under which he took rest. Waqa alayhi salatu wasalam ne gane draft ke saaye ke niche wahan aaram farmaya. اسی اسلام میں یہاں محدث لکھتا ہے کہ غورث بن حارث ایک مشرک تھا. He was a polytheist and the enemy of the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم and he saw Allah رسول lying on his own and he had this evil desire کہ اب قدرت نے مجھے یہ موقع دیا ہے کہ اب میں محمد کے نام کو صفائے ہستی سے مٹا دیتا ہوں. اس نے اپنی تلوار کو نیام سے نکالا, took his sword out of its sheath and started dangling over the Prophet علیہ السلام. اپنی ننگی تلوار کو مصطفیٰ کریم علیہ السلام کے مقدس چہرہ مبارک کے اوپر سے لٹکانے لگا. تو جب آقا علیہ السلام کی اس اسلام میں آنکھ کھلی. But we have to remember here that the closing of the eyes of the Prophet of Allah does not donate on the fact that Allah the Rasul is asleep. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, O my sahaba, tanamu aynaya wa la yanamu qalbi. My eyes are closed and my heart is all awake. For the reason being, it is attentive towards the wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Mustafa Kareem's heart goes to sleep, then the eyes of the heart go to sleep. Who will be ready to receive the wahi and inspiration of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And we see here at the night of Miraj, Mustafa Kareem says, my heart is taken out. Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti rahmatullah alayhi writes, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that I see that my heart has two ears with which it listens and my heart has two eyes with which it sees. These were the eyes and ears bestowed by Allah Kareem which could see and hear from millions and millions of miles away. This was a speciality of Mustafa Kareem alayhi salam. So, tanamu aynaya wa la yanamu khalbi, that my eyes are closed but my heart is still awake. Jab uski talwar wo lehrane laga, started to wave his sword around aur aqa ali salat wa salam ki aankh mubarak khuli to wo kehne laga, ya muhammad man yamna'uka min, are ya muhammad ye to bata ki ab tujhe mujhse kaun bachayega. Who is going to save you from me? I am going to kill you now. I've got a snaked sword here and I'm going to kill you. اللہ اکبر. سرکار دو عالم علیہ السلام نے جب دشمن کے یہ الفاظ سنے, when he heard these words of that dushman, of the enemy of Islam, and the Rabi writes, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't fear the slightest. And آقا علیہ السلام نے اس کے اس سوال کے جواب میں ارشاد فرمایا, اللہ will help me. رابی کہتا ہے کہ آقا علیہ السلام کے زبان مبارک سے یہ نکلنا تھا کہ اللہ مجھے تجھ سے بچائے گا, محفوظ رکھے گا. وَاللَّهُ يَقْسِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Beloved, Allah will save you from the evilness of the people. For the reason being, our beloved, فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. We are always observing you. Our protection and help is always with you. Allah's Rasul says, Allah will help me. And when Mustafa Kareem alayhi salatu wasalam said, Allah, Rabi says that the sword, due to the fear of the name of Allah, fell from the hand of Waris bin Haris. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam picked the sword up and waved it at his face and said, "May yamna'uka min." Waris, tell me, who is going to save you from me? Allahu Akbar. Waris bin Haris says, look what he has to say. Typically he says, "Kun khayra akhizin." Aur Waris wo mushrik kehta hai, yani aap apne mukhalif par kabu pa kar uske saath acha sulook karte hain, aap unme se ho jaye. Aapne mujhe kabu kar liya, mujhe maaf farma de. Sarkar e alam Ali Salatu Wassalam ne use maaf farma diya, chala gaya apni qaum ki taraf aur elan karte hue har ek kisi se yahi kehta hua, "Jitukum min indi khairin nas." Logo, wo shakhs جو تمام لوگوں سے بہترین ہے, تمام کائنات والوں کے مخلوق سے بہتر ہے, for his morals and his manners. For this reason, Rabb-i Kainat says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَزِيمٍ. So we see, وہ خدا نے ہے مرتبہ تجھ کو دیا نہ کسی کو ملے نہ کسی کو ملا کہ کلام مجید نے کھائی شہا تیرے شہر و کلام و بقا کی قسم because your مقام is so raised O Prophet of Allah because your eloquency and your loftiness is so great for this reason رب کائنات takes the قسم of your town of your fathers of your house of your mother of every single person through whom settled in the womb of Sayyida Amina radiallahu ta'ala. So we see that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forgives him. But even more amazing than this, the Ummah radiallahu ta'ala anhu who has done such a great favor upon the Ummah, only one realizes. We see that before migration, Hijrat se pehle, ye ek dustoor tha, ke log زائرین کعبہ ہر سومار کو اور ہر جمعرات کو کعبے کی زیارت اندر سے کرتے So it was a routine within the people of Makkah that one man who had the key of the Kaaba he would open the door of the Kaaba on a Monday and he would open the door of the Kaaba on a Thursday and people would come And people would do the tawaf of the Kaaba. لوگ آتے کعبے کا تواف کرتے اور کعبے شریف کی اندر سے زیارت بھی کرتے جو کچھ میں کہنے جا رہا ہوں بہت سارے محدثین جن میں امام ترمذی رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ امام ابو داؤد اور امام مسلم محمد بن اسماعیل بخاری رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ نے اس حدیث پر جرح و تعریف کی ہے فرماتے ہیں کہ اس وقت جس شخص کے پاس کعبے کی چابی تھی اس کا نام تھا عثمان بن طلحہ عثمان بن عفان یہ اور ہے عثمان بن طلحہ اور وہ اپنی بیتی what happened to him وہ خود سناتا ہے he mentions itself what happened عثمان بن طلحہ says that it was a Monday and people came in a large group to visit the Kaaba and in this group was Muhammad the son of Amina radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he says people came forward and as they about they wanted me to open the door the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered me and said Usman Kaabe ka darwaza khol de aaj mera ji chahta hai ke main apne Rab ko Kaabe ke andar se dakhil Usman kehta hai ke main aapki baat ko sunu meri nasib chahiye حالانکہ آپ نے اپنے آباء و اجداد کے دین کو چھوڑ دیا you have left the deen of your forefathers and you want me to listen to you I'm not going to listen to you میں آپ کے لئے دروازہ کھولنے کے لئے تیار نہیں I will never open the door for you I'll open the door for all these people but I'm not going to open the door for you اور عثمان خود کہتا ہے کہ میں نے مصطفیٰ کریم علیہ السلام کی بارگاہ میں ایسے نازیبا الفاظ کہے ایسی غلط باتیں کہیں جن سے کسی کی جن سے کسی کی بے عزتی ظاہر ہوتی ہے somebody is disrespected because of these words عثمان کہتا ہے the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stayed quiet he didn't say anything عثمان کہتا ہے جب میں نے اپنی بات ختم کی تو پھر آقا علیہ السلام نے ارشاد فرمایا یا عثمان لَأَلَّكَ سَتَرَا هَذَا الْمَفَاتِحَ يَوْمًا بِيَدِي أَدَعُهُ حَيْسَ شِتُّ عثمان یاد رکھنا آج میں تجھے کہہ رہا ہوں کہ کعبے کا دروازہ کھول میرا جی چاہتا ہے میں اپنے رب کو کعبے کے اندر عبادت کروں سجدہ کروں اور آج کو دروازہ کھولنے سے انکار کر رہا ہے عثمان یاد رکھنا ایک ایسا وقت بھی آئے گا کہ یہ کعبے کی چابی میرے ہاتھ میں ہوگی اور میں جسے چاہوں گا عطا فرماؤں گا عثمان کہتا ہے whatever comes out the mouth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he knew وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى he does not speak from himself it will come true one day ایک نہ ایک دن یہ بات سچی ہو جائے گی عثمان کہتا ہے یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کیا جس دن کعبے کی چابی آپ کے ہاتھ میں ہوگی آپ کی ملکیت میں ہوگی کیا اس وقت قریش کا ترہ جو قریش ذلیل و خوار ہو جائے گی ان کی عزت نہیں ہوگی سرکار دو عالم علیہ السلام ارشاد فرماتے ہیں اللہ رسول سے بل امیرت و عزت جس دن کعبے کی چابی میرے ہاتھ میں ہوئی اس وقت قریش کی امامہ کا ترہ جو ہے وہ آسمانوں کو چھو رہا ہوگا they will be blessed because مصطفیٰ کریم will be their leader and is their leader عثمان says کہتا ہے کہ فتح مکہ کے بعد کافی عرصہ گزر چکا مکہ فتح ہو گیا وآقا علیہ السلام واپس تشریف لائے the prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم came back to مکہ المکرمہ and مکہ المکرمہ was conquered when it was conquered آقا علیہ السلام نے کعبے کا طواف فرمایا people were forgiven as you all heard from علماء and مشایخ that how the prophet علیہ السلام forgave these people when مصطفیٰ کریم entered into مکہ let me just mention a point here today I'm sure there will be non-Muslims listening to this speech and people will come to a point of realization that مصطفیٰ کریم's birth was the annihilation of terrorism مصطفیٰ کریم's birth was the annihilating and the finishing of all extremism. Aqa alayhi salatu wasalam, as he enters into Makkah, as we hear from Mashayikh, we see an army of 10,000 Sahaba ikram, starting with one man from Makkah to Makkah, now returning with a mighty force of 10,000 Sahaba ikram. And with them we have Sayyidina Bilal al-Habshi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who is the one who calls to the Sahaba ikram. Whenever Allah Rasul wants to say something to the Sahaba ikram, he calls Sayyidina Bilal, oh Bilal, tell the Sahaba to do this, order the people to do this. And this time Mustafa Kareem alayhi salatu wasalam is quite a distance from Makkah to al-Mukaddama and calls Sayyidina Bilal. Before I carry on and continue with the happening of the key, calls Sayyidina Bilal and says, oh Bilal, stop the whole convoy here. Stop the army here. We cannot afford to enter Makkah into this through these gates or through this path. We will have to change our direction and go from a different altitude into Makkah al-Mukarramah. Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala says, Ya Asta, how can this be? 10,000 Sahaba ikram? Hundreds and thousands of horses and camels with all their luggage and fighting gear with them? You're telling me to stop them? How can I stop them? Bilal, tell them to stop. Because we want to change our direction into the entrance of Makkah al-Mukarramah. And the only reason for this is Mustafa Kareem was not sent as a mercy to humans, was not sent as a mercy to angels, was not sent a mercy to anyone else, but was sent as a mercy to every single living creature. Bilal, I see with the nur of Nabuwah that a few kilometers down this path, there is a bitch who has given birth to little babies, and Mustafa Kareem does not want that his men trample over the babies of a cat, of a bitch, and be blamed for it. For this reason, I would like to show my mercy to that kitten and chain the entrance into Makkah al-Mukarramah. Allah Rasul enters into Makkah al-Mukarramah. And we see that ulama mentioned that, as I've been mentioning over many Fridays, the modesty of Allah Rasul, his head was bowed upon his she camel, and then doing the tawaf of the Kaaba. And the kuffar come running along. The Rabi says, people were standing on their houses. People were standing on building tops. Other people had shut their doors on the Prophet ﷺ. But he says the masjid was so full that there wasn't a single room to put down a needle. And people, the Prophet ﷺ came to them people. And he asked them, do you know what I'm going to do with you? Allahu Akbar. And Hudud Ya'lama writes again. He says that they say that you are the merciful. Anta kareemun. وَابْنُ كَرِيمٍ وَابْنُ أَخِرِ كَرِيمٍ You are a Kareem, you are the son of a Kareem, and your father was a Kareem, your uncle was a Kareem, they were all generous and merciful. Have mercy upon us. If Mustafa Kareem wanted, every single person could have been annihilated like many thousands and millions are annihilated today in this dunya. But Allah Rasul said the same thing. I will say to you, whatever Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam said to his brothers, إِلْهَبُوا وَعَنْتُمُ الطَّلَقَى Go, I forgive you. You can go for today. Then Usman bin Talha is called. Allah Rasul says to Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala, call Usman bin Talha. Usman bin Talha says, I came running with the key. And I had it in my hand. Mustafa Kareem put his hand out. And I automatically put the key in the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jab bina khiyar Usman kehta hai, کہ مصطفیٰ کریم علیہ السلام نے جب مجھے طلب فرمایا تو میں نے بلا ساختہ وہ چابی سرکار کے ہاتھ مبارک میں رکھ دی اور آقا علیہ السلام نے ارشاد فرمایا عثمان یاد ہے نا وہ دن اس دن میں تجھے کیا کہا تھا کون سی بات تجھے کہی تھی ایک ایسا دن آئے گا جب یہ چابی میرے ہاتھ میں ہوگی اور میں جسے چاہوں گا اسے عطا فرماؤں گا I will give it to whoever whomever I wish عثمان کہتا ہے میرے پاس اور کوئی الفاظ نہیں تھے I had nothing else to say I had nothing else to request nothing else to mention عثمان کہتا ہے مصطفیٰ کریم علیہ السلام کے قدموں کے ساتھ لپٹ کر میری زبان سے بے ساختہ یہی نکلنا ہی تھا اشہد ان لا الہ الا اللہ وانک محمد رسول وہ کہتے ہیں عثمان ہو چکا اس کے بعد آقا علیہ السلام نے وہ چابی اپنے ہاتھ سے لی اور پھر سیدنا عثمان بن طلحہ رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ کے ہاتھ میں رکھی اور آقا علیہ السلام ارشاد فرماتے ہیں خذوها خالدتن طالدتن لا ينزعها منك الا ظالم عثمان ابھی مجھ سے لے لے تجھے نہیں دے رہا تیرے آنے والی نسلوں کو دے رہا ہوں آج بھی دیکھیں سعودی عرب کی مملکت سے پوچھے وہ لوگ کون ہیں جن کے پاس کعبے کی چابی ہے اور یہ شرف ہے ان کے پاس کہ وہ کعبے کی صفائی کرتے ہیں کعبے کی دیکھ بھال کرتے ہیں وہ تمہیں یہی کہیں گے یہ وہ لوگ ہیں جو عثمان بن طلحہ کی فیملی میں سے حضرت علی رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ نے ریکویسٹ کی اے اللہ کے رسول ہم حجاج کا خیال رکھتے ہیں عمرہ کرنے والے جو لوگ آتے ہیں ان کا خیال رکھتے ہیں ہم چائے زمزم سے پانی پلاتے ہیں اے اللہ کے رسول ہمیں یہ شرف آپ عطا فرمائیں کہ ہم کعبے کی جو چابی ہے وہ ہمیں عطا فرمائیں give us the key of the Kaaba of Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم and this was the uncle of the Prophet علیہ السلام who asked for this oh Allah Rasul don't give the key to Usman give it to us we will be from the Hashimis we will be from the Muttalibis we will be from the family of the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم but the Prophet of Allah said this is not the day of revenge Mustafa Kareem has not come for revenge but has come to give more and more love to the people of dunya. Usman was given the key and Mustafa Kareem's forgiveness was expressed to the whole universe. Millions of historians have read this happening of the forgiveness of Makkah al-Mukarram. Millions of people, Muslims and non-Muslims alike have read the forgiveness of Mustafa Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it is only due to this character of Aqa alayhi salatu wasalam that solely and only Islam has spread to all four corners of the universe today. After the place we see, the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasalam is doing the tawaf of the Kaaba all on his own. Aur fatah Makkah ke baad, Aqa alayhi salatu wasalam ki khulke azim ki ziya paashiyan ka zuhur حضرت فضالہ ابن عمیر he was known to be one of those people who would openly drink and I have mentioned this in many gatherings in this masjid but just to revive our iman and refresh ourselves to realize that this gathering was not just to go into the masjid from Salatul Maghrib till Isha listen to the talk oh Krishna Sahib very good What did he say? It was like saying, somebody went to a talk and I asked them, what did the Imam talk about? Oh, it was a very good talk. It was absolutely good. What did he talk about? Subhanallah, he was great. But we need to remember what has been said and try to learn a lesson from it. So let it not be that today we come into the masjid and listen to this 1 hour talk and go home and I don't know anything about the character of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Look at it through the eyes of Fuzala ibn Umair. Fuzala says, I was standing all my own. And he says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was on his own. One man to one man. He was doing the tawaf of the Kaaba. And what I'm about to say to you are more or less 99% the exact words of most honorable, our spiritual guide, Ya Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who gave this speech in 1982. And bihamdillah, I translated word to word, to phrase, to sentence, and I learned it all. Fuzala ibn Umair says, I was standing there, and Fuzala says, I saw that every single Sahabi Rasul is busy in their responsibilities. There is no God. There is no security of the Islamic forces. With the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And I'm standing outside the Kaaba. And Fuzala kehta hai ke shaitan bhi mere dil mein ye waswasa dala ke تعالیٰ دیکھ تو صحیح مسلمانوں کا لیڈر اکیلے طواف کر رہا ہوں, کوئی باڈی گارڈ سامنے نہیں ہے, کوئی اسلامک فورسز کا وہ چیف ان کمانڈر ساتھ نہیں ہے. تو اب زالہ بات یہ تب بنے گی کہ اب جا اور مصطفیٰ کریم علیہ السلام کو السلام کو پیچھے سے وار کر کے نبوت کے نور کو بجا دے and blow out the light of prophecy, اور قیامت تک تیری آنے والی نسلیں تیرا ذکر کریں گی. The whole generation and your family and your lineage will carry on taking your name and your zikr until the day of judgment. That job and duty with people like Abu Lahab and Atba and Shayba and Ubayd ibn Khalf and all these people could not do. Suraqah ibn Malik tried, but he could not do either. But his horse started to go into the Rocky Mountains. But Fuzala go ahead now. And when Mustafa Kareem does his tawaf of the Kaaba, walk behind him and attack him, and you will be able to blow out the light of prophecy. Fuzala said this was a hallucination, a waswasa, as we have gone through the chapters of Baba Waswasa in the writings of Imam Waliuddin Muhammad bin Abdullah Tabrizi al-Amari, who writes in Mishkat al-Masabid, waswasa, this was the waswasa of the shaitan. This was the hallucination of the shaitan. And we see that Sayyidina Fuzala, after he became Muslim, he walked into the car. Zala kehta main peeche peeche chalta raha. Ab Aqari Salatu Wassalam ne tawaf apna mukammal karne ke qareeb the, to main bhi Aqari Salatu Wassalam ke peeche ho liya. Aur meri niyat ye thi ki Aqari Salatu Wassalam par hamla karke noor e nubuwwat ko main bujha dunga taaki qiyamah tak aane wali nasle mera zikr karengi, qiyamah tak jitne bhi aane wale log hain mera zikr karenge, mera charcha hoga. Fuzala kehta hai jab hi main Aqari Salatu Wassalam ke qareeb pahuncha, تو سرکار دو عالم صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم وہاں رک گئے. The Prophet علیہ السلام stopped. میری طرف آقا علیہ السلام نے مڑ کر ارشاد فرمایا, ایک روایت کے مطابق افضالہ, کیا تو فضالہ ہے؟ حضرت فضالہ جو اس وقت اسلام نے قبول نہیں کیا تھا وہ کہتے ہیں نام یا رسول اللہ انا فضالہ, یا رسول اللہ فضالہ. تو سرکار نے پوچھا یہاں کیا کر رہے ہیں؟ مجھے نہیں ہے, all on your own. There's nobody in the masjid. Everybody's busy in doing whatever they are. The only person in the masjid is the beloved of Allah, the master of Medina, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fuzala, what are you doing here? Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, میں تو یہاں مسجد کا نظارہ دیکھنے کے لیے آؤں, یا دیکھیں کتنا پرسکون ماحول ہے, اللہ کی بات کرنے کے لیے آؤں, تسبیح کرنے کے لیے آؤں. اللہ تعالیٰ سلام, come to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the masjid. مصطفیٰ کریم علیہ السلام اسلام ارشاد فرماتے ہیں تعال یا فضالہ, کہا اے فضالہ میرے قبیل قریب تو ہو جائے. فضالہ کہتا ہے میں آقا علیہ السلام کے قریب ہوا, سرکار دو عالم علیہ السلام نے مجھے تبلیغ کی, نہ مجھے دعوت دی. اللہ رسول نے کہ میری دعوت اسلام دن میں نے تبلیغ to me, didn't ask me to read anything, but all what he did, اتنا کیا کہ اپنا دست مبارک میرے سینے پر رکھ دیا. اللہ کے رسول کے دست مبارک کا میرے سینے پر رکھنا تھا. It was just the putting of Allah Rasul's blessed hand on my chest. Fuzala کہتے ہیں میرے دل کی دنیا ہی بدل گئی, مجھے پتہ ہی نہیں چلا کہ کیا ہوا, اور بے ساختہ میری زبان سے یہی نکلا I requested of Allah Rasul, مجھ پر وہی کرم فرمائے جو آپ نے ابو بکر صدیق رضی اللہ تعالیٰ کو فرمایا ہے. سرکار فرماتے ہیں نکال اپنا ہاتھ. فزارہ کہتا ہے کہ میں نے اپنا ہاتھ نکالا, حضور علیہ السلام کے دست مبارک پر رکھا. I put on the hand of the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, اور سرکار نے فرمایا پڑھ اشہد ان لا الہ الا اللہ محمد رسول اللہ. اب فزارہ نے اسلام قبول کیا. And this is the point I want to take the attention of all those hundreds and thousands of brothers and sisters listening on the radio today, that Fudala was someone in whose veins alcohol would run day and night. Fudala was the one who would day in and day out sit with another woman illegally, talk to her and commit illegal actions before he accepted Islam. Now he has accepted Islam. And Fudala says, میں نے جب اسلام کو قبول کیا تو میرے آقا علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کو الوداع عرض کر کے مسجد سے نجا نکلا, گھر جا رہا تھا. اور فزارہ کہتا ہے کہ ہر روز میرا یہ معمول تھا, it was my routine that every day when I would go to the Kaaba I would specifically go out through that door and walk through that path, اسی راستے سے میں گھر جاتا. حضرت فزارہ رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ ارشاد فرماتے ہیں کہ اس دن بھی کہ جس دن میں نے اسلام قبول کیا اپنی روٹین کے مطابق اسی دروازے سے نکلا اسی باب سے نکلا اور گھر جا رہا تھا اور یہ کس راستے میں اس لیے because on this path there was a woman who used to stand in her balcony all well dressed for me and when I would walk out of the door she would see my path and see my way that Fulala is coming today Fulala is going to sit with me we're going to chat together we're going to have some tea together and we're going to talk and so on and so forth اس عورت کا یہی ارادہ تھا کہ حضرت فضالہ فرماتے ہیں کہ ہر روز روٹین کے مطابق جب میں کعبے کا طواف کر کے نکلتا اسی دروازے سے اسی سڑک پر اور وہاں ایک عورت میرا انتظار کرتی جہاں وہ بن سور کا میرا انتظار کرتی میں اس کے ساتھ روز بیٹھا ہم چائے پیتے کپے لگاتے آج بھی اس دستور کے مطابق وہی عورت اسی بالکونی میں کھڑی تھی she was standing in the same balcony waiting for me and Fuzala says ویسے تو اسلام قبول کرنے سے پہلے میری حوصلہ آنکھیں اس کا تعاقب کیا کرتی تھی کہ وہ کہاں کھڑی ہوگی کس طرح کھڑی ہوگی کون سے کپڑے اس نے پہنے ہوں گے that my eyes would be darting out at her to look at her that where would she be standing how would she be dressed how would she have her makeup on but Fuzala says آج I had accepted Islam اور آج نہ مجھ سے میری گردن اٹھائی جا رہی تھی نہ میری آنکھیں اٹھتی تھی جب میں کعبے سے نکلا تو میری آنکھیں بھی زمین پر لگی ہوئی تھی اور میری گردن بھی زمین پر لگی Fuzala says جب اس کے گھر کے پاس سے نکل گیا when I walked past her house تو تھوڑے دور جب نکل گیا تو اس نے آواز لگائی یا خدالا اے خدالا کیا بات ہے کیا وجہ ہے کہ اتنی ناراضگی اتنی بے وفائی کہ اے خدالا اتنا وقت گزر چکا ہر روز تو میرے پاس آتا ہے آج تو نہ اپنی گردن کو اٹھا رہا ہے نہ اپنی آنکھوں کو اٹھا رہا ہے کس چیز نے تجھے مجھ سے ناراض کر دیا what is it that I have put this kind of disagreement in your heart and you're not happy with me why aren't you looking at me تو اہلیان رشتل سنیے حضرت فضالہ رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ جن کی گھٹی میں شراب کی بوتلیں بچپن ہی سے پڑی ہوئی تھی وہ عرض کرتے ہیں اور اسے کہتے ہیں اے فنا اس کام سے اللہ اور اللہ کا رسول ہمیں منع فرماتے ہیں اللہ اور اللہ کا رسول tells us not to do these things اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ رسول says not to look at women اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ رسول says don't drink alcohol اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ رسول says do good things and take what Allah's Rasul gives you and put away which he tells you to stay away from this is Islam and this is the reality of Islam and this is tonight's message that all those people listening that if every Muslim acts upon خُزُو مَا عَدَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ وَلَوْ مَا عَدَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَعْخُزُو hold what Allah's Rasul gives you and take away and put away to one side which brings upon the displeasure of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam if every Muslim realized that what am I doing will Allah like it will Allah's Rasul like it it is the completion of Iman and Taqwa that on the day of judgment when that sinful man will be presented in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah Kareem will say to him it will be only him and his Lord And Allah will say to him, Ama istahyayta min istahyayta min? Ya mere bande, duniya mein, jab tu akele baith kar, koi nahi dekhne wala tha, na teri biwi thi, na tere bacche the, na teri maan thi, na tere tera baap tha, koi bhi nahi tha. Us waqt raat ke andhere mein tu guna kar raha tha, you were annihilating, that you were trespassing on the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, kya tujhe mujhse sharm nahi aayi? کہ میرا اللہ مجھے دیکھ رہا ہے didn't you have shame that Allah is looking at me ایک اور مقام پر امام بخاری رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ نے اسی حدیث کو اس طریقے سے نقل کیا کہ حضرت آدم علیہ السلام سرکار دو عالم علیہ السلام کی بارگاہ میں حاضر ہوں گے ہی وہ سے عرض کریں گے یا رسول اللہ کا سلام کہ آپ کو پتہ نہیں ہے وہ آپ کو گھوم دی اس کے ساتھ کیا ہوا ہے اللہ اکبر راوی کہتا ہے کہ آقا علیہ السلام will run in the Maidan of Mashar that his black shawl which he wore, his mantle which he wore, it will fall off his shoulders and he will intercede in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by putting a piece of paper on the scale and the sinful person will request, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, any actions that I have done, they have not been accepted in the court of Allah. What is this that you have put upon the scale, a piece of paper which has outweighed my wrong deeds and my shortcomings? Mustafa Kareem will say, this is your iman. is your belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah Kareem give us a few moments tonight to go home and think that each gathering in these 12 mosques is not just a gathering every year and just finishing and that's it. It's a gathering of contemplation. It's a gathering in which a person rectifies themselves. And if a person seeks forgiveness in the blessed month of Ramadan al-Mubarak, if Allah can have mercy upon Abu Lahab, which Imam Bukhari mentions, Imam Mustalani mentions, Imam Askalani mentions, all the Shari'een of Bukhari write that due to Milad, Abu Lahab has been blessed with the decreasement of azab in Jahannam, then cannot a Muslim and a woman be blessed with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Indeed, 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 he can. May Allah give us all tawfiq to enjoy in goodness, refrain from evil, and try to rectify our own selves, that when we do that, others will follow suit. May Allah give us all tawfiq to enjoy in goodness, refrain from evil, and try to rectify our own selves, that when we do that, others زبان کچھ اور کہتی ہے آپ کچھ اور کرتے ہیں ذہن کچھ اور کرتا ہے تو ہمیشہ رب کائنات کی بارگاہ میں یہی دعا کرنی چاہیے مولا یہ ہمارے فعل اور ہمارے کہنے اور کرنے کے درمیان جتنے تضاد ہیں اللہ کریم دور فرما دے اور اللہ کریم ہمیں اپنی اصلاح کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرما اپنے گھر والوں کی اصلاح کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرما تاکہ ہمیں مصطفیٰ کریم اور رب کائنات کی بارگاہ میں سرخوری حاصل ہو آمین وما علینا الا البلاغ المبین انشاءاللہ العزیز ہمارا بقیہ پروگرام ختم انشاءاللہ العزیز پڑھا جائے گا تو ختم سے پہلے دو شیر سلام کے انشاءاللہ العزیز پھر ختم پڑھا جائے گا پھر مختوم محترم حضرت العلام مفتی مدیر الزمان صاحب دامت نقاط القدسیہ آخری دامی دعا فرمائیں گے اس کے بعد نماز پڑھی جائے گی نماز کے فوراً بعد آپ کی خدمت میں انشاءاللہ العزیز لنگر شریف پیش کیا جائے گا اور یہ پوسٹر جو ہمارے یہاں سائن بورڈ پر لگا ہوا ہے یہ میلاد مصطفیٰ کانفرنس جو وینسڈے کو ہونے والا ہے تو انشاءاللہ عزیز یہاں رشتوں سے کچھ کوچے جا رہی ہیں یہ سپر سٹور ہے سپاٹلینڈ روڈ پر تو وہاں ٹرانسپورٹ انشاءاللہ عزیز کا بندوبست ہے تو اس پوسٹر پر ٹیلی فون نمبر بھی لکھا ہوا ہے جو آپ جانا چاہتے ہیں ضرور تشریف لے جائیں ایسی محفل کو مصطفیٰ کریم نے ارشاد فرمایا کہ جنت کے باغ ہیں جہاں اللہ اور اللہ کی رسول کی محبت باندھی جاتی ہے تو اللہ کریم ایسی محفل میں ہمیں تعاون کرنے کی شرکت کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے اب آپ اس امکان کھڑے ہو جائیں